It's great to have you here, and I'm very glad that you made it here in December. It's the first attempt of ours to have this meeting in the winter time. We used to do this in May, and we always felt guilty about having the nice weather outside whilst we're sitting inside. So today, hopefully, there's no lost weather opportunity. I welcome Dr. Lehr here. Good morning, Eric. Nice to have you here. So it's great to have you here, and I just wanted to mention a couple of introductory things. Lee, should I have control here? Yes. So the goals of our meeting are to update you on some important developments in spine trauma care, improve awareness. I think last night's session, for all those who were there, was really sobering and eye-opening. We had some tremendous and terrifying cases in terms of how devastating things can be if subtle things are missed, and the challenges of society are always increasing with an aging and more diseased population. We want to share experiences. Again, this is one of those great opportunities in these learning events that we can share our victories, but also openly discuss our defeats and try to learn from those. Clearly, I think we want to set some common expectations and have a truly meaningful exchange that also includes, obviously, in the lab with direct hands-on exposures. So this is the increasingly common scenario, and we'll discuss this patient and other things later in the day. A 95-year-old female who lives by herself crashed her own car that she was driving at 60 miles per hour, and she's neurologically intact, and there's a nice large family that's sitting around now asking you to make grave decisions. And aside from never letting her drive again, the consequences and anything that we do are very important. And again, this is something that when I was in medical school, a young doctor, I never, ever contemplated having to decide on. A very unique opportunity is that for the first time, we actually do have an increasingly unified language in terms of spine trauma and how to classify it, thanks to AO. And I'll introduce one of the eminent members of AO here who is very involved in these projects. This is obviously not a slide to be read in terms of detail, but this is a very important attempt at trying to finally come to a consensus how we express ourselves. And we still have a lot of things to do, and again, this is something we'll talk about later. Subtleties are still not quite clear, and we have interesting geographic variations where, for instance, our German-speaking countries always up-classify the severity of injuries compared to the North American brothers, and Asia sides more with America on this one. So it's fascinating if you look at this from a global perspective, how we still struggle with things that we kind of have. And obviously, the choice of treatment will be a very important subject today, and something that you'll see some unique live demonstrations on that I think have never been done before. Thanks to our fellows, for instance, we've had a artificially created burst fracture that we're going to show a variety of techniques of how to treat these. We'll also have a dislocated neck that Dr. Sasso and Dr. Daly will show how to realign with closed techniques. So these are some exciting things that I hope you'll find interesting in terms of live cadaver demonstrations. It's a really huge honor and pleasure to introduce our faculty here. And I want to really recognize Drs. Andrew Daly and Dr. Rick Sasso from the University of Utah and from the Indiana Spine Group, who are here since 2015 when we had the first spine trauma meeting to raise awareness of this somewhat frequently overlooked but important entity of spine care. So both are tremendous teachers and long-term friends, and so is Dr. Dan Gelb. He is the chair of the Fellowship Committee of AO Spine North America and has been a, am I on an auto timer or what is happening here, Lee? I'm kind of struggling, okay. He's a tremendous resource and just always a stalwart, and you see him to be a straight shooter. Rod Asgreen is going to join us a little bit later, and he's obviously one of the godfathers of minimally invasive lateral surgeries. And it's also a huge honor to have Josh Schroeder here from the Hadassah Hospital in Jerusalem. And he will show us some unique techniques and some insights of approaches towards trauma care that we just are not that exposed to necessarily, and also some high-tech angles that our regulatory burden does not allow us to partake in. We have obviously world-class facilities, and again, through live demonstrations, through panel discussions. For instance, session 5 will be a so-called pecha kucha style, where your questions and everything like that will be most welcome. Our phenomenal faculty will sit up front and take any of your questions, and I'll pique hopefully their interest and controversy with a couple of pre-prepared slides. But the hands-on opportunities are a huge opportunity for any and all of you. And again, it doesn't get better, and I always learn a lot and learn tips and tricks from our great visiting faculty. As we're doing this, we'll miss an icon of our institution. Gary is having significant health challenges, and we really wish him all the best as he's undergoing some major life challenges in healthcare. And we wish him a speedy recovery, because his smile and his expertise is very much always beloved. And I really struggle a little bit with not having him here today, but our group and our support staff at SSF is phenomenal. And again, we'll have an audience response system. In the back of the room is Mackenzie. She's awesome, and we've worked with her for many years. This is something that allows immediate feedback opportunities for us as speakers, so we can kind of direct the discussions accordingly. It does allow trend changes, so for instance, before and after questions, before and after lectures, for instance. And it does allow for anonymous sampling. So for instance, last night we did a hands up, hands down thing, but this is a far more elegant way to have anonymous sampling. To test this, I'll ask you to take your little keypads and just ask a first question. We have a tight timer, so we don't lose too much time with these questions. So question number 1 is, your preferred sports team, just as a practice question, Huskies, Cougars, or number 3? So please answer number 1, 2, or 3. Seth, why are you raising your hand? You may not leave the room. We have a majority of people who do not care for either sports team. All right, so Dan Gelb pushed the button 5 times, I guess. Now let's do a second question that's a little bit more to the point, and this is from last night from our whiskey tasting. So what is your preferred whiskey? 1 Scotch single malt, 2 Japanese, 3 Irish, 4 bourbon, which we did not feature last night, and 5 I don't drink whiskey. And Cliff, I swear I'm not watching your hand on the keypad. Okay, so here's your selection time. And we have abolitionists in tight contest with American whiskey drinkers. So this is a clear statement for me to include bourbon next year. And the final thing, and this is now a medical question that goes into the topic selections for instance, session 5. What would you like to see happen today in terms of some of the things that we discussed? Are you just interested in that general overview? Would you like to see latest surgical techniques? Would you like to hear about spinal cord injury care, review spinal injuries in the elderly, or managing complications? So 1 through 5, 1 selection, please. And I hope that that drill will not accompany us all morning long. Wow, that's a very even distribution. So managing complications and spine injuries of the elderly are clear, preponderant selection. So this is a great help for us as we're managing our discussions later today. I'll switch back to the regular slides, Lee. So thank you for your answers, and expect questions pretty much for most things. This meeting would not be possible without generous industry support. I really want to recognize Globus as a primary sponsor, and DePuy Synthes and Nuvasiv. Please go to the exhibits of Integra, Medtronic, Precidian, and C-Spine as well, and interact with our industry representatives. This is a unique opportunity and a protected forum to exchange ideas, and hopefully our industry members will also see what matters to us as clinicians.